Boat automate! Hey there, how are you? Integrating Dynamics 365 and model-driven Power Apps with SharePoint is a great feature, since it allows you to leverage all the document management capabilities of SharePoint. And it's also very easy to set up, and you can even have all the folder creation process automated for you. But the naming of the folders, well, it could be better. My name is Jorge, and in this video, I will show you how to automate the creation of folders in SharePoint for accounts with nice looking folder names. Setting up a SharePoint integration is really easy. Go to the Power Platform admin portal, select the environment you want to enable for SharePoint integration, click Settings, and then Integration and Document Management Settings. From here, start by selecting Enable Server-Based SharePoint Integration. This will start a wizard where you will select online or on-premises SharePoint location. And if you select online, you will specify the URL of the site. The site will then be validated and you're good to go to the next step, which is Document Management Settings. Here, you will select the tables for which you want to enable the integration and also re-enter the site's URL. Finally, you are given the option to have the folder structure created for you. You can do that, but let me show you how those folders' name will look like. They will look like this one with all that gibberish following the account name. Not great, is it? On the other hand, you don't want to be creating all those folders by hand. So, who are you gonna call? Power Automate! Power Automate! That's right! Power Automate will do the job, and if you stay until the end of the video, I will share a link you can use to request the flow, and I will gladly send it your way. Now, let's take a look at that flow. It triggers with a new account getting created, and then it uses an environment variable where the URL for the site is stored. With that, you can go and get the site's ID, which we do with the list rows, and then a compose to get the first result of the list. The relative URL will be the entity, in this case, account. That allows us to get the document location's ID, again with the list rows, and then retrieving the first result. We can now create the folder, indicating the URL of the site and the folder path. Finally, we need to create the new document location, which I am doing in two steps simply because it refused to set the parent location on record creation And so that is being done in this update a row action. Let's give this a try. Let's create a new account. Create new folder and save. Okay, let's check SharePoint. Create new folder there. Let's go back to the model-driven app. Refresh here. Okay, create new folder, files. And there it is. Let's upload some files. So upload, choose a file. Okay, an image. Okay. Let's check SharePoint. There's our image. Now let's upload one from this end. Okay, maybe this one. And let's check back the model-driven app. Do a refresh here. Files. And there's the other image. Great stuff, right? So here's the link you can use to ask for the flow, and I will send you a solution with it. And that's a wrap. I hope you found this one useful, and please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. See you soon.